सेदटीका उभय रूपे तस्मिन् वाक्ये ज्ञानस्य अर्थवत्व अनुपत्तिम प्रमाणयति प्रमाणयति और अन्यथा अनुपत्तिम एक्चुअली दैट दिस तत्वमसी उपदेश इज गिवन सो वाक्य ज्ञानस्य इस वाक्य ज्ञान वाक्य मीन्स महावाक्य वाक्यम ज्ञान मीन्स ज्ञानम दैट इज बॉर्न एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ द उपदेश ऑफ महावाक्य सो दैट इज कॉल्ड ज्ञानम दैट इज ज्ञान वृत्ति ऑफ द रिकग्निशन द कॉग्निशन दैट अराइजेज इन मी दैट आई एम ब्रह्मन दैट एवरीथिंग इज ब्रह्मन दैट कॉग्निशन दैट अराइजेज इन मी can only arise as a result of the teaching of the Mahavakya Tattvamasi, whenever it arises. And whichever way the Upadesha is given, ultimately, only that Upadesha, in whichever form it is given, alone can bring about the recognition that I am Brahman. There is no other way that you are Brahman. It is that Upadesha alone can bring about a recognition that I am Brahman. Upadesha can be given in any language, in any word, but this must be the spirit of the Upadesha, that you are what you are seeking, that you are not what you take yourself to be, and that you are what you want to be. So whatever idea I may have about what I want to be, that must become clear that I always want to be Brahman, and that you are Brahman. So whenever that knowledge takes place, that always takes place as a result of this teaching. It can happen that we may understand this teaching after a few births. You know, sometimes they tell a joke, you know, and then it takes time to understand that joke, and then all of a sudden the person laughs. So I mean, the enemy is very fond of saying this, you know. All of a sudden the fellow laughs, you know. And the people laugh, you know. So anyway, similarly also it may take its own time to understand the meaning of this vakya, tattvamasi, or respond it with aham brahmasmi. So whenever the response comes as a result of the cognition taking place in the mind, it always comes in response to this teaching that it is praptasya praptahi and it is, you know, nitya nivruttasya nivruttahi, nitya praptasya praptahi. It is that when it becomes clear to me, that then the cognition, then the knowledge or realization takes place that I am not what I take myself to be. That means there is Brahma about myself and the drop off. This one sentence does that. It has the capability of removing all the notions about myself. And as a result, when the recognition comes that I am Brahman. So, vākīya jñānasya anyathā anupatti. This vākīya jñānam could not be there unless the jñānam be removed. This upadesha cannot be given by the śruti, upadesha cannot be given by the śruti unless there was ignorance. Shruti says tattvamasi. Why should Shruti say that? When my eyes show a red color, it cannot be unless the red color is. That is the nature of the pramanam, that it reveals the truth. And similarly also Upanishad is a pramanam which says you are Brahma. So that knowledge dispels the ignorance about the self. And so this Upadesha would not have been given unless this truth was there that I am Brahma. And therefore, whenever I say I am not Brahma or I think I am not Brahma, that is ignorance. Therefore, ignorance is that which veils the true nature of myself, and that to remove that veiling is the purpose of the Upadesha Tattvamasi. So therefore it is said, Ubhaya Rupe Tasmin Ajnane. Ubhaya Rupe means what? That which has the rupa of the avarana and vikshepa, vakya jnanasya arthavatva anupattim pramanayati. That anupattis vakya jnana would not have been there unless there was ignorance to dispel. And therefore, the ignorance is. So, there is something called ignorance. That also is a great debate. But the thing is that ignorance is because this the Upadesha is by the Pramana. That's one of the things. Therefore, the verse said, Tattva Masyadi Vakyotha Jnana Badhyam. Ignorance is that which is Badhyam, which is dispelled by the Jnanam, the knowledge that arises from Tattva Masyadi Vakya Upadesha. And that, what does that ignorance do?
कूटस्थ वपुष प्रतीच संगकारकम, दैट कूटस्थ वपु एंड प्रत्येगात्मा दैट इज कूटस्थ चेंजलेस, सो समहाउ इट कनेक्ट्स इट विद उपाधि. पुरुष प्रकृतिस्थो ही भुंगते प्रकृति जान गुणान, पुरुष प्रकृतिस्थ है, सो पुरुष दैट ऑब्टेन्स इन प्रकृति मीनिंग द आइडेंटिफाइड द प्रकृति, एंड सो दैट इज हाउ द आइडेंटिफिकेशन arising from the veiling of one's true nature happens because of the ignorance. Atmanah sakshitvadi anupatti api tadakshayipikayatyah. That Atma is called sakshi. That is also because of ignorance. Yan nimittamedi. So the verse says, यन निमित्तम च साक्षित्वम, आत्मा गेन्स द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ साक्षी. सो आत्मा गेन्स द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ क्षेत्रज्ञ. एतद्यो वेति तं प्राहो क्षेत्रज्ञः, सो वन नोज द क्षेत्र इज कॉल्ड क्षेत्रज्ञ. सो आत्मा गेन्स द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ क्षेत्रज्ञ, द नोअर ऑफ द क्षेत्र, और साक्षी द विटनेस ऑफ द क्षेत्र. रियली द विटनेसिंग ऑल्सो इज नॉट प्राइमरी इन आत्मा. Still, you require someone to illumine everything and then everything else is illumined. So this difference is created. Actually, the duality of the illuminator and illumined is created also by ignorance. Inasmuch as there is something that is illumined, and illumined is that which stands apart from illumined. And that is how the Atma gains the designation of Sakshi of the illuminator or the witness. Yan nimittam cha sakshitvam. So yet means ajnanam, that becomes nimitta for the concept of sakshitva. Karanatvam, tatha, similarly also, Atma is called the cause. It means the cause also, but inasmuch as we see the effect. So ignorance creates the idea of effect. Ignorance creates the idea of effect or creation or product. And therefore, it requires us to conceive of a cause. And that is how Atma is looked upon as the cause of the creation. That idea of the cause can be there provided the idea of effect is there. The idea of effect itself is created by ignorance. And that's how Atma gains the designation of the cause of the creation. And therefore this ignorance is that which gives designation to Atma of Sakshi, of Karanam. Because the question arises all the time, Swami, you say that Atma is Sakshi. Atma is witnessed, stands apart from the universe or the upadhi which is witnessed. Are we talking about the duality? Or if Atma is a cause and cause is something different from the effect, again are we talking about the duality? No. Even the causality or even the witnessness, witnesshood also is the idea that is accepted momentarily in order to divert or in order to focus our attention to the self. Ultimately recognize that in the very dimension of witness, when the true dimension of witness is recognized, that nothing is left out. Although in the beginning we talk about the Atma, Anatma, Viveka and separating the Atma from the Anatma, but when the Atma is truly recognized, then we realize that even Anatma also does not stand apart from the Atma. There is no boundary that can separate Atma from something else, and that's how it is recognized that Anatma also is only within the Atma. And to recognize that Atma is independent of Anatma and Anatma is not independent of Atma, that is the recognition. So when we say Atma, Anatma, Viveka, the Viveka is not one being different from the other, but what one enjoying a Satta which is different from the other. That Anatma is Mithya and Atma is Satyam. Satyam is that which is independent, and Mithya is that which is dependent. It is this recognition alone makes it a total proper recognition. Yan nimittam chi cha sakshitvam karanatvam tatha atmanah. Similarly also, that Atma gains the designation of Sakshya, the Karanam. Sarva karya vinasepi yad bijam avashishyade. So, that ignorance is what? because of which the Atma is called Sakshi, because of which the Atma is called Karanam, that ignorance, sarva karya vinashepi, even when the entire karya is destroyed in pralaya, yad bijam avashishyate, the bijam of the very seed of the cause, that continues to remain, that is, the ignorance doesn't get destroyed even in the pralaya. That's what the Tika says. Pralayado Linasya Karyasya Punarutpatyano Patihabi Tat Kalpikayatyaha. Pralayado Linasya Karyasya. That in pralaya that karya becomes completely leanam, meaning completely get merged, it merges into the cause. That is, in the pralaya the karya or the effect loses again its independent manifestation and merges into the cause, that's into the state of causality. Then karyasya puna utpatti, and again when the next cycle of creation comes and that karya again comes to manifestation, all of these also is tatkalpika. This whole idea of the creation, sustenance, dissolution, you know, all of this also tatkalpika. All of this is projected by ignorance. Yad bijam utpatti sthiti bhanganam iti sambandha, then there is connected to the next verse. Tad atma jyotishayuddham sata nityam eva avatishtate tad ajnanam atma jyotisha iddham. That ignorance, that is iddham, is given by atma jyotisha. Atma jyoti means the light, the consciousness, that is the self. Nityam eva avatishtate, that doesn't get destroyed. That's why the word nityam was used, that at least as far as ignorance is concerned. It's a pravaha nityatvam. Ignorance is nityatvam also, as far as the vyavaharik satta is concerned. Ignorance is one kind of nityatvam, vyavaharika nityatvam. Atma is nityatvam, paramarthika nityatvam. That is why two kinds of nityatvam, they want to then say pravaha nityatvam and kutastha nityatvam. So there is one nityatvam where there is a constant change, like the flow of the river, but it remains. Like pravaha. Never the same, but remains nevertheless. Whereas other nityatvam is that which does not, is changelessly eternal, and changefully eternal. That is how. Suttad atma jyotisha iddham. That ignorance is that which is illumined by the atma jyoti. Iddham sat. Nityam eva is not sun, but sat. Nityam eva avatishthate. It always remains. Utpatti sthiti bhanganam yad bijam avashishyate. So utpatti, sthiti and bhanga, all of these take place, the seed of that which avashishyate, that always remains. Navedmiti sakshitaha. Now the Vatikara is trying to prove the existence of ignorance. Navedmi, number one, ignorance is, how do you say, because of sakshi is, Atma is called Sakshi because of ignorance. Atma is called cause because of ignorance. And then there is the Utpatti Sthiti Bhanga. And when all this takes place, the fact is that when Utpatti takes place, so when creation takes place in any particular cycle of creation, that can only take place when there is a bijam or the seed present. A person can wake up in the morning only when there is a seed of waking up. That is a deep sleep. So deep sleep has a seed of waking up. And whatever this person does during waking, the seed, the cause is there in the deep sleep, seeming also. Then the universe comes into manifestation is because there is a seed, that is in the pralaya. And navedmiti, that also the Tika says here. Tasya svatantram vyavartayati tad atma jyotisha iddham. This ignorance is not svatantram, atma jyotisha iddham, so that is illumined by the atma jyoti. Anuva siddhatvata sadhakantara apeksha. Ignorance doesn't require something else to prove itself. Anuva siddhatvata. Ignorance is directly experienced by us, therefore you don't say even, actually karyanumaya also it is said, maya. That maya is that which is inferred by the presence of the cause and the effect. But anuva siddhatva, ignorance is something that is immediately experienced by all of us. How? Navedmeti. So navedmi itita sakshitaha. And so navedmi, I do not know. That itself shows that there is ignorance. Sakshitaha so anubhavat bhati iti sheshaha. Sakshitaha iti sakshitaha so anubhavat bhati. So we say that the ignorance is because there is a direct experience, that the sakshi, it is sakshi bhasyam, illumined by the sakshi, and there is an immediate experience that I do not know. So ignorance also, immediate experience, therefore ignorance is. But it's partantra. It can, its existence can never be established unless it is illumined by the Atma Jyoti. Then the Tika says, Sakshitvasya Vastutvat Yan Nimittam Disakshitam Kathamuktam. Vatvikara said that Atma gains the designation of a witness also because of ignorance. That is, ignorance creates a duality between the witnessed and witnessed, then witness, you know. Even the duality is first created. The duality between subject and object is first created. That there is an object. There is something separate from me, the subject, that duality is first created, that is also done by ignorance. And having created the idea of duality, then Atma is the witness or the drashta, and everything else becomes drushyam. Even the duality of drug and drushya is created by ignorance. That is the reason why ultimately Atma is not even as a sakshi. So all these words such as sakshi, karanam, all of these words also ultimately drop out. Ultimately, we have to know Atma by the Lakshyartha. So, well, all of these words take me pretty close to the Atma, all right? Ultimately, the word also has to drop. And then, knowledge of the Atma is devoid of the idea of the witnessness, or devoid of the idea of causality, devoid of any idea, devoid of even the idea of the knowerness or the knownness. No such idea has to be there. That's why it is Nirvikalpakam Jnanam. And she will discuss that, how in that knowledge there cannot be any kind of an idea that I knew Atma as a witness, or I knew Atma as a cause, or I knew Atma as whatever. If it is known as something, then again that becomes limited. And so all these words help us to drop them. And that is, of course, what a word always does. When we use the word pot, that's what the word does. The pot word, the sound and the concept. So the word part sacrifices itself completely to give way to the concept part. So part is a sound and it creates the concept in our mind. When? Only when the word drops. That is when the concept flashes in my mind of the part. So the word always sacrifices itself. Similarly, the word sakshi has to sacrifice itself to create in my mind the right cognition of the Atma. That's why they talk of Vachyartha and Lakshyartha and this Lakshanavritti, that Lakshanavritti. Whatever you say, there is nothing that can really explain it, but it is Anirvachaniyam, however, ultimately. But still, you can't just say Anirvachaniyam, just raise your hands and not say anything. And therefore, you try to explain it as much as you can, as close as you can. Knowing fully well, yato vacho nivartante, ultimately the words cannot fully explain it, but still, that doesn't mean you will not use words. You will use them so that you are propelled into that, you know, where the words are not necessary. So, that propelling is required, the rocket propels. Ultimately that thing goes in its own orbit, doesn't require any rocketing, you know. But for it to go into that, rocketing is required. And so, the words are required. Ultimately, knowledge doesn't require, it's devoid of the idea that is created by the word also. Anyway, going back here, sakshitvasya vastutvat. But we say that the sakshitvam, the Atma is really sakshi. Sakshitvasya vastutvat. Vastutva means that is real. Sakshitvam or the Atma is witness is a real thing. Then yan nimittam the sakshitvam iti katham uktam. Then how do you say that the sakshitva of the Atma is because of ignorance? We say that Atma is sakshi by itself. Not that Atma is sakshi because of ignorance. How do you say that Atma, the sakshitva of the Atma is due to ignorance? Tatraha kutasthaiti. Then the verse is, kutasthaiva sakshi atra swamoha abhasa hetutaha. Kutastha eva atra sakshi. See, sakshi is that who is subject to change. Sakshi is that who is subject to change with reference to what is witnessed. So, kutastha cannot be sakshi. So, what is sakshinaha ka vikarita? Or vikarasya ka sakshita? How can vikara become sakshi? Because sakshi must so, sakshi, if it is to be kutastha, then that changes. And therefore, what we call sakshi has to be nirvikara. Because sakshitam also cannot be primary. But anyway, here it goes a step further. Kutastha evatra sakshi. Here we say that the sakshi is the one who is kutastha, changeless alone is sakshi. Atra swamoha abhasa hetutah. How come kutastha is called sakshi? Swamoha abhasa hetutah. Moha means ignorance. Because of the ignorance that is illumined by that very sakshi, because of the ignorance that, since the moha ignorance is there, that ignorance is illumined, then we say that the one that illumines ignorance is sakshi. That is how the sakshitva of the atma also is on account of ignorance. Then the Tika says,
yadva parinaminah sakshitvat na tatra ajnana peksha idyasankyah kutasthaiti. Or somebody says that atma is parinami. At one point he said that atma is really sakshi, you don't need to say that sakshitvam is due to ignorance. Or you can say atma is parinami, therefore is sakshi.
Yadva parinamina sakshitvat na tatra ajnana peksha. That atma is parinami, changeful. And therefore sakshitvam, or being the witness, is the nature of atma, because atma is changeful. So you don't have to say that the atma's sakshitvam is due to ignorance, because atma is changeful. So atma being changeful, you don't require ignorance, you know, for it to make atma sakshi. He is sakshi because he is changeful. Iti asangya kutastha. No, atma is not changeful, atma is kutastha. So sakshi has to be parinami, atma is aparinami. Therefore, he cannot be sakshi. Therefore, sakshitvam also cannot be primarily there in atma, and still we call atma as sakshi and feel that atma as sakshi is only because of ignorance. Atra meaning what? Parinami buddhyadav iti avata. So kutastha eva sakshi atra. Atra means what? Buddhyadav. Buddhi and everything else which is parinami, changeful. With reference to them, atma is called kutastha. Even that word also. Even kutastha also is what? Changeless. See, the thing is that for us to be able to understand any word, if the meaning of a word is always understood with reference to something else. Even changeless also is understood with reference to change. Sakshi is understood with reference to sakshya. Drashta is understood with reference to drushya. They don't like that. When you understand atma in reference to something, that means that you don't understand it as is. Every word always is related to some other word, and there is always sambandha. And there is always a vishesha. Either some vishesha is there or sambandha is there. But the knowledge of the atma must be devoid of vishesha and sambandha. So ultimately, only when the sakshi leads me to the knowledge of the self that is not connected to drishya or something, when I understand the atma is drashta, not connected to drishya, then alone the word drashta has done its job. So this discussion ultimately is meant to enable us to know the atma. Atra parinami buddhyadav. Atra kutastayav atma sakshyatra. Tasya sakshitva hetumaha. Why do you call him sakshi? Swamoha abhasa hetutaha. Because of ignorance. Swamoha abhasa. Because the self-ignorance is illumined, or self-ignorance is there, and because of that alone, the atma is called sakshi. But then prashna, mohasya vastutvat, but who says that moha, ignorance also is real? Mohasya vastutvat. na tat kritam api tatha.
See, for the Tikakara to know what is actually intended by the Vartikara also, so Vartikara goes on his own track without clarifying or filling all these gaps, you know. So one must really know what must be his train of thinking to be able to see what question he keeps on answering, you know. So here the Tikakara also must have a tuning up with Vartikara, that he knows what steps are involved and he's jumping. And to fill in the gaps, you must know what is the thinking process going on in the mind of Vartikara, which makes him write in a certain way. Anyway, mohasya vastutvat na tat krutam api tatha. We say that moha or ignorance also is real, and therefore sakshitvam is not created by ignorance. So na tat krutam api tatha. Iti asankyah, even ignorance also is not real. Avicharita samsiddhi tamaha, I guess it must be one word. I don't know. Avicharita samsiddhi. Unless avicharita samsiddhi tamo anubhava samshrayat. Or samsiddham, I don't know what it is, but avicharita samsiddham, if it is so, tamaha anubhava samshrayat. So, avichara samsiddham, in short, ignorance is there as long as avichara is not done, or wrong vichara is done. Avichara samsiddham, suppose we read it that way, then what is tamaha? Tamaha is what? Avichara samaha, ignorance is there only as long as vichara is not done. See, the question was mohasya vastutvat. We say that moha, ignorance also is real. But that alone can be called real, which cannot be negated or which cannot be sublated. Inasmuch as ignorance can be negated or dispelled by knowledge that is generated from vichara, therefore it is said that avichara samsiddham tamaha. Ignorance is there as long as samsiddham is established or remains as long as vichara is not done. Vicharam na sahate maya can never tolerate vichara and inquiry. Like a minister, as Swami always used to say, so like a minister cannot tolerate an inquiry, you know. We'll fall apart, and so also maya falls apart, but it remains very tangible until one inquires into what is. So, avichara samsiddham tamaha, the tamaha is only established because of lack of vichara, wrong vichara. Vichara is not absence of vichara, but vichara in a wrong way, or if vichara is inquiring, then until because of lack of inquiry, alone the ignorance is. When the inquiry is pursued, ignorance no more remains. This is pramanikasya kutaha avicharitattvam. But we are just saying that ignorance is something established by pramana. How do you say avicharitattvam, that is only a product of avichara or of the nature of avichara? Then it said anubhava samshayat. Tamaha anubhava samshayat. That means, navedmi iti anubhava is there, that I do not know. That ignorance is the only pramana that we have for establishing the presence of ignorance. But it is not a real vastu because it can be dispelled by the vakya jnana, badhyam. And therefore it is not real. And it is this moha which creates the ideas of sakshitvam, karanatvam, etc. Anubhavadeva tamasiddhim sadhayati. So we say that tamasiddhim, the ignorance that exists, that ignorance is established by experience. Nisakshikahayati. The verse says, Nisakshike navedmiti na kathanchit prasiddhyati. Nisakshike. If there is no sakshi of something, then nothing can, the existence of anything can be established only when there is a sakshi. That's a basic rule. That something is, that existence can be established only when there is a sakshi, when it is witnessed, when you are aware of something. So that the pan is, can be said only when there is an awareness of the pan. That means there is an aware of the pan. Who is aware of the pan, then alone the existence of pan can be established. And therefore, always, nissakshika samsiddhi is not possible.
the existence of nothing can be established unless there is a sakshi. So there is nisakshikena vedmiti na kathanjit prasidhyati. If ignorance is not illumined, then na vedmi, that I do not know, that can never take place. So na kathanjit prasidhyati. So never this prasiddhi can be there that I do not know. You know? And that's how ignorance is something that is illumined by the sakshi. When we say that, we temporarily accept the difference here between ignorance and sakshi. Says Anandagiri, the Tika here, tamasi sakshi anapekshe na vedmi iti na tadbhanam. Tamasi sakshi anapekshe. If you say that ignorance does not require the sakshi in order to be there, that is called real. Real is that which does not require anything else in order to be there. It should be self-revealing also. We say that ignorance cannot reveal itself unless there is sakshi to reveal it. Tamasi sakshi anapekshe. If tamas did not require sakshi in order to illumine itself, na vedmiti na tadbhanam, then this bhanam, I do not know, would not have been there. That shows that ignorance is illumined. Ni manat evam bhanam tasya svanivartya asadhakatvad ityartha. Ni manat evam bhanam. We say that the ignorance itself is self-effulgent, therefore you know. Says tasya svanivartya asadhakatvad. The thing is svanivartya. Nivartya is what? That which dispels it. In fact, the ignorance is established. Presence of ignorance is established by knowledge which dispels it. So pramanam cannot be like that. Pramanam is that which can never be dispelled. Or pramanam does not depend upon the existence of that which dispels it. Here ignorance depends upon the presence of knowledge which dispels it. So sva nivartya sadhakatva sadhakat sva nivartya asadhakatva. Sva here is knowledge and nivartya is that which is dispelled by itself. So sva nivartya becomes ignorance, you know. So agnana asadhakatva, it means that if pramana means that which is, it does not require ignorance to establish itself, pramana is self, that means it establishes itself. Pramanam is that which is self-revealing, and we say that ignorance is not self-revealing. Ignorance is known only when it is revealed by the Atma, and therefore it is not a real vastu. It requires sakshi to establish its existence. Then says here, Atma ched ajnana sakshi, tari yatha swarupena sa tat sakshi, tat anyatra visyadit asankyaha. Atma ched ajnana sakshi, if you now say that, Atma is sakshi of ajnana, because you said that ignorance cannot establish itself, existence of ignorance can be established only when it is illumined by the Atma, so Atma is a sakshi and that is how the existence of ignorance is established, that ignorance is not a real vastu, it is not self-effulgent. Had it been real vastu, it would not have depended upon knowledge which dispels it. It would have been independent. Here ignorance depends upon the knowledge. Even to establish the existence, ignorance depends upon the knowledge which dispels it. That is never the nature of the pramanam. It doesn't depend upon the ignorance or doesn't depend upon the opposite of itself. So atma ched ajnana sakshi tarhi yatha swarupena sa tat sakshi. So if you say that now atma is sakshi of the ignorance, then if that is the swarup of the atma to be sakshi of the ignorance, anyatra apisya, then how about karanam, etc.? Anyatra means what? If atma is sakshi by nature, then why not atma is karanam also by nature and atma is everything else by nature? Therefore the verse is tathayati. Tatha kutastha samvitke nitaram na etadishyade. Tatha kutastha samvitke nitaram na etadishyade. Now that is explained by the Tika. Yatha sakshina abhave. tamasah asiddhi kutastha samvitke. So kutastha samvitkam. So kutastha samvit, samvit also means actually knowledge only. So samvit here has to be only understood as knowledge. So that which is illumined by kutastha, that's kutastha samvitkam. The samvita knowledge of which is due to kutastha atma. So yatha sakshina abhave tamasa asiddhi. Just as with, in absence of sakshi the tamas cannot be established, tatha nirvikara chidrupe tamonapekshe sakshini sutrameta tamona siddhyati. Tatha nirvikara chidrupe. So the idea is that the tamas requires the sakshi to establish itself, but sakshi does not require tamas to establish itself. That's the idea. So anvaya vyatireka, that you do not know, that means the ignorance cannot exist unless it is illumined by sakshi, whereas sakshi can exist even when ignorance is not. Sakshi is there where the ignorance is, but sakshi is there even where the ignorance is not. Whereas ignorance cannot be, ignorance is there where the sakshi is, ignorance cannot be where the sakshi is not. So this anvaya vyatireka. Yatha sakshina bhave tamasa asiddhi tatha nirvikara chidrupe tamo anapekshe sakshini. So also sakshi that is nirvikara chidrupa, tamo anapekshe, which does not expect the tama, require tama, sutram etat tamah na siddhyati. Therefore, so it is said here, tatha kutastha samvitke, that ka pratyaya is doesn't, kutastha samvit. So the atma is of the nature of kutastha samvit, nitaram etat, etat means what? Ajnanam naishyate. Ignorance is no existence in the atma who is kutastha samvit swarupah. That means ignorance requires atma to illumine, but atma is independent of ignorance. This is how the satya and mithyatvam is established. Satyatvam mithyatvam. The tika continues. Swayam siddhuma samarthyat sadhanantarahanatah vadakasya sadbhavat tamasa sakshitachitehe. Swayam siddhuma samarthyat, ignorance cannot establish itself. Sadhana vadakasya sadbhavat, ignorance is that also which can be dispelled by ignorance. And sadhanantara hanatah, there is no other sadhanam other than the atma. So there is no sadhanam other than atma to establish that ignorance. Swayam siddhuma samarthyat, which itself cannot establish itself. Badakasya sadbhavat, then there is badaka, there is knowledge which is there. Tamasa sakshita chitehe. Therefore, even the sakshita, see, even chitehe sakshita, that we say that the atma is sakshi, even that concept also. Swayam asiddhum, swayam siddhuma samarthyat, that witnessness of the atma also cannot be established except ignorance. And badakasya, even the witnessness of the ignorance also is dispelled in the wake of the knowledge. And the atma is witness, even that idea is also dispelled in the wake of the true knowledge of the atma. Therefore we say, tamasa sakshita chitehe. That the chite is sakshita, that the chite is the sakshi only because of ignorance. Because that also is dispelled. That the witnesshood doesn't remain independently. It is only as long as ignorance is. Svapara nirvahakattvam cha tasyoktam iti bhavah. Svapara nirvahakattvam cha tasyoktam. So, svapara nirvahakattvam, that means that tasya, atma is that which is svanirvahaka and para nirvahaka, that's how it will say. Atma, nirvahaka means one who obtains by himself, and para nirvahaka, that. So atma is that which establishes its own existence as well as existence of everything else. Okay, sakshitvade avidyatvam upasamharati. How? Sakshitvam is an idea that is, it is brought about by ignorance. So then the verse says, aishvaryam karanatvam cha sakshitvam avichatmanah. We say atmana aishvaryam, the glory of the atma. Karanatvam, atma is the cause. Sakshitum atma is sakshi, the witness. All of these what? Sadeshita or sateshita. Sateshita means sata ishitavya. कार्यार्थ साक्ष्यार्थेन अस्य संगतेः. सो वी कॉल आत्मा ईश्वर. ईश्वर मीन्स व्हाट? द रूलर. हाउ डू यू कॉल हिम द रूलर? बिकॉज ईशितव्य संगतेः. ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द ईशितव्य एसोसिएशन ईशितव्य दैट विच इज रूल्ड, आत्मा इज कॉल्ड रूलर. और कार्यार्थ, सो बिकॉज ऑफ द एसोसिएशन विद द कार्य ऑफ द इफेक्ट ही इज कॉल्ड कारणम. साक्ष्य, बिकॉज ऑफ द एसोसिएशन विद दैट विच इज विटनेस्ड ही इज कॉल्ड विटनेस. सो दिस इज यथाक्रमम संबंध हियर. ऐश्वर्यम कारणत्वम साक्षित्वम. ईशितव्य कार्यार्थ साक्ष्यार्थ, दैट इज हाउ दे आर कनेक्टेड. सो दैट इज हाउ इट इज ईशितव्य दैट क्रिएट्स द आइडिया ऑफ ईश्वर इन द आत्मा. इट इज साक्ष्य दैट क्रिएट कार्य दैट क्रिएट्स द आइडिया ऑफ द कारणत्वम इन द आत्मा. इट इज साक्ष्य दैट क्रिएट्स द आइडिया ऑफ साक्षित्वम इन द आत्मा. एंड दैट दे आर रिलेटिव कॉन्सेप्ट्स, नॉट एब्सोल्यूट कॉन्सेप्ट्स. That's why it's called avidyakam. That's what Tika says. Nahi sapeksham swarupam swabhavikam aswabhavikam cha avidyam rajatavat. Nahi sapeksham swarupam swabhavikam. So atma is sakshi only with reference to sakshya. Drashta is with reference to drashya. When drashya goes away, drashta also goes away. See, the idea of the drashta can be there only as long as drashya is there. Idea of cause is there as long as the effect is there. So as long as the pot is there, pot is a karya, then we can call the clay is karanam. But suppose my attention is changed from the pot to the clay. As long as the idea of the pot is there, so long the idea of clay as a cause is there. Until then the clay assumes the status of cause. But when I realize that the pot is really nothing but clay, when the idea of pot goes away from my mind, then the idea of clay is free from the idea of causality. See, idea of clay is associated with the idea of causality as long as the idea of pot is there. So only when I understand the clay with reference to pot, that I understand the clay as a cause. But when I understand the clay by itself, then the idea of causeness also is not there. That means that the clay was cause. That is only the causality of a clay was only with reference to the karyatva, the effect of the pot. But otherwise, by itself, clay is not the cause. In this example, similarly that atma is sakshi, only with reference to sakshya, it is karanam, only with reference to karya. That is, when the atma is looked upon from the glasses of karya, then we call him karanam. When we look upon the atma from the viewpoint of the sakshya, we call him sakshi. When we look upon Atma from the standpoint of Ishitavya, those who are controlled, Bhisha, Smad, Vata, Pavare, so long we call him the Niyanta. By himself is not Niyanta. All these ideas are created in Atma by ignorance only. So, Sapeksham, Nahi Sapeksham, Swarupam, Swabhavikam. So, Sakshi, Karana, Ishvara, all these ideas are relative ideas. And the relative idea or relative thing cannot be the Swarupa. Aswabhavikam cha avidyam. And anything that is aswabhavikam is always created by ignorance. Anything aswabhavikam, anything changing is caused by ignorance. Every name and form is changing caused by ignorance. Rajatavat ityartha. Like rajata is there now, but not there when the knowledge, you know, shuktika takes place, so it is avidyakam. Rajatatvam of that object is aswabhavikam. Therefore it is avidyakam, caused by avidya. ये तो केचित ऐश्वर्यम अनारोपितम आश्रयन्ते. सम पीपल डोंट लाइक दिस. यू व्हेन यू से दैट ईश्वर आल्सो इज अ रिलेटिव आइडिया, वेदांतिन्स गो ऑल द वे, यू नो दैट दैट इज व्हाट कॉजेस इमोशनल प्रॉब्लम देन. सो दे वांट टू इवन नॉट इन ऑर्डर टू इन एनी वे लुक डाउन अपॉन ऐश्वर्य ईश्वर. But that ultimately in the knowledge of the absolute, the idea of Ishvara also should resolve. So what? Then they will declare Ishvara also is mithya. You know? That hurts. Ishvara is mithya. Not Ishvara is mithya in as much as the Ishvaratvam being a relative idea Therefore, it is mithya, meaning that one has to even transcend that idea also. One has to drop that idea also. That's all. But kechid aishwaryam anaropitam ashrayam. No, no. Aishwarya, the rulership, the overlordship is anaropitam. Anaropitam tattvam. That's the true nature. Te puna aishwaryam karanatvam cha ityadi vartikartham na alochayante. They do not realize that. Sakshitvadi nirvahakam anuvadati. So how self-ignorance is nirvahakam? So that swapara nirvahakam, I don't know, then that can be even ignorance also, swapara. That ignorance also nirvahakam of itself and of sakshitvam, or atma is nirvahaka of himself and of the ignorance also. But swajnanam sakshitvadi nirvahakam anuvadati atma iti. So the verse is, आत्माज्ञानम् अतः प्रत्यक्ष चैतन्या भासवत्सदा आत्मनः कारणत्वा करणत्वादि कारणत्वादे प्रयोजकम् इहिष्यते. अतः देवर आत्मज्ञानम् सेल्फ इग्नोरेंस प्रत्यक्ष चैतन्य अवभासवत् सदा. द सेल्फ इग्नोरेंस दैट इज पोजेस्ड ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्टेड कॉन्शियसनेस सदा आत्मनः कारणत्वादे प्रयोजकम्. इन शॉर्ट द सेल्फ इग्नोरेंस that itself enjoys a reflected consciousness, becomes the cause for imputing the status of causality to the Atma. That is called nirvahakam. So, not karanatvade, but I think karanatvade prayojikam hiya ishare. Atmana asangatvade hi atas shabdartha hai, atah hai. Since Atma is asanga, therefore he cannot even be sakshi. And still you call him sakshi, that is brought about by ignorance. But ignorance is not swasiddham, it is something that is illumined by Atma. Yehedi karyadi uktihi, yeha ishyate, yeha means what? Karye, or sakshye, or ishitavye, I guess that's all. Then the last verse is sakshitvam avidyaka muktva tataha. Sarabuddhyadi siddhiti uktam nigamayati. So thus, even the sakshitvam of the Atma also, their idea is due to ignorance. Having said that, tataha, sarabuddhyadi siddhi, from that ignorance alone, tataha, from that ignorance is the siddhi. From everything from buddhi, everything is created from ignorance. Iti uktam, which was already stated, nigamayati, that is concluded here, chaitanya, in the last verse. Chaitanya bhasavat pratyang mohantat pratyagatmanah buddhyadeir vidhya vishayantasya siddhisya sakshinastatah. Chaitanya abhasavat pratyang moha. Pratyang moha means pratyagajnanam, the self-ignorance. Chaitanya abhasavat, that enjoys the abhasa, the reflection of the consciousness. Mohantat pratyagatmanah buddhyadeh vishyantasya siddhi syat. Oh. So, chaitanya abhasvat pratyang mohantat pratyagatmanah. So, pratyagatma, that is even within that ignorance, that is illumined by the reflected consciousness, buddhyadehe vishyantasya siddhi syat. Sakshinah tataha. Buddhyade, begin with buddhi, vishayantas, ending up to vishaya. Sakshinah tataha siddhisyat. Yes, chaitanya abhasavat vaan pratyang mohaha tadantaha sakshi. That's what the first part said. Mohantat pratyagatmana, the pratyagatma is that which is within the ignorance also, that is illumined by the reflected consciousness. Tasmacha praticha, that's what it is. So, that pratyagatmana, the tataha is pratyagatmana. Ultimately, everything is from pratyagatma. So pratyekatmanah, that is the fifth case. Buddhyadehe vishayantasya siddhi syat. Pratyekatmanah tatah pratyekatmanah sakshinah buddhyadehe vishayantasya siddhi syat. So pratyekatma is a sakshi who is within even the ignorance. From that, the whole universe begins from buddhi. All of this is there. The existence of all of this is due to the sakshi that is inner even with reference to ignorance. So tasmacha pratichaha, praticha also fifth case, buddhyadehe siddhi, buddhyadehe is sixth case. So from that pratyagatma, the buddhi and everything has emerged, or everything is illumined by that. So that is sattasvurti pradata of everything beginning from buddhi all the way up to vishaya, that is the... Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra-bhāśya-krutau vande bhagavantau punah punah Īśvaro-guru-rātmeti murti-bheda-vibhāgine Vyomavat-vyāpta-dehāya dakṣinā-murtaye namah Om shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om. Yoyam Vijnanamaya Praneshu Sudyantar Jyotif Purushaha Sasamanas Sandbho Loka Vanusancharde Jhāyatīva lelāyatīva Sahiswapna bhūtvemam lokamatikrāmate Smritya rūpāṇe Now we are on the page 1009. Bhāshyakara has explained so far, katam ātmā iti yoyam vijñānamayaḥ chalaiḥ prāṇeṣu hṛdyantas jyotihi. This far has been explained. Purushaḥ Now earlier it was said Jyotihi avbhasakatvad atma uchyate tenahi avbhasakena atmana jyotisha aste palyayate karma karude chetanavanivaheyam karyakarana pindo yatha aditya prakashastho ghataha. So just as a pot is illumined by the light of the sun or pervaded by the light of the sun, yathava markadadir manihi kshiradidravya prakshiptaha parikshnaya atmachyameva tat kshiradidravyam karodhi. So just as an emerald or such precious stone when placed for examination in liquid like milk or water, how it imparts its luster to the entire fluid or liquid. Tādhrugeva-etadātmajyotihi buddhervi-hrudayāt-sukshmatvād hrudyantastamabhi-hrudayādikam kārikana-saṅgādam jekikṛtya-ātmajyotiṣṭhāyam-karodhi. Similarly also is ātmajyoti, even though remaining within the heart, it imparts its luster consciousness to the entire karyakana sanghada. Parampareena sthula sukshmatardamya sarvantaradamatvat. Because there is a parampara, a sequence of sthulata beginning from atma all the way up to vishayas, there is a increasing degree of grossness, or the other way around, increasing degree of subtleness. Just as an increasing degree, that is why one thing can impart its consciousness to another. That is a purpose behind the increasing degree. So
sarvantaratamatvad, and atma is sarvantaratama. So there is sarvantaratvam, the antaratvam is there, that compared to the vishaya, the object, the body is inert, compared to the body, the sense organs are inert, compared to that the mind is inert, compared to that the buddhi is inert, but compared to all of this, atma is sarvantaratama. Now continuing on page 1009, buddhe atma-chayatvam samarthayate. How the buddhi receives the atma-chaya, that consciousness of the atma, samarthayate, that is being now supported here, or that is being supported here with logic, buddhistavate. Buddhistavate svachatvat anantariyacha atma chaitanya jyotihi pratichhaya bhavati tenahi vivechinamape tatra atma abhimana buddhis prathama. Buddhistavada. Tavada means prathamam. To begin with, buddhihi svachatvat. So buddhi is svachya. Svachya means that is transparent. He is clean, pure or transparent svachya. So svachatvat, like the water in a lake, when it is placid. So svacham means placid, becomes transparent. Anantariyacha. And also is anantariya, it is closest to the self. It is transparent or placid. At the same time, the buddhi is in subtlety closest to the self. Anantariya, footnote number 2. Svakarana agnyanamatra vyavahitatvevi indriyade apeksha buddhehe abhi anantariyat ityathaha. So the idea is that indriyade apeksha, as I just said, as compared to the sense organs and others, buddhehe abhi anantariyam. So buddhi also is inner. And svakarana agnyanamatra vyavahitatvevi. The only thing that separates the buddhi from atma is ignorance. So ignorance is the very cause of creation of the buddhi, and that alone separates the buddhi from the atma. And so that is why it is said anantariyat. So even though not anantariyat, it's not immediately after atma. That's why api shabda is there. Svakarana agnyanamatra vyavahitatva api. Even though there is a screen between the buddhi and the atma, and that is one of ignorance, so that screen is there a little bit. Otherwise, so after the ignorance, so that there is a Dridrishya Viveka, another text would say that the ignorance is the first thing that receives the reflection of consciousness, the cause. And then it is passed on to the other layers of the effect. And so anyway, so anantariyacha. So that is why anantariyam here is the closest. Even if ignorance receives that reflection of the consciousness, it is not some, is not known to us. And so buddhi is the first manifest, let us say that, buddhi is the first manifest element, or manifest principle, and that is why that is the first one that receives the reflected consciousness. Atma chaitanya jyotih pratichhaya bhavati. It should be one word actually, pratichhaya. Atma chaitanya avasavati bhavati. So Atma-Chaitanya Jyoti or Atma-Chaitanya Abhasavati Bhavati becomes endowed with the reflection of the Atma-Chaitanya, the consciousness that is Atma. So this is the Paramparaya is being explained here. How Paramparaya Sthula Sukshma Tartamya. So now the Sthula Tartamyatvam, so Buddhi is Tavat Sukshma. So sukshma tama, you can say, compared to all the material elements, so material layers. And then tenahi. So tena means, says Anandagiri, laukika parikshakanam buddhau atma abhimana bhantim ukte arthe pramanayati. This Ukta artha is what? That the Buddhi is the first one that receives the reflected consciousness with reference to that. That is, pramana, it shows here how this is true. Laukika parikshakanam, laukika, footnote number 9. Shastra asamskrita dhiya laukikaha. Being people who do not have this abala, gopala, you know, so beginning from bala up to gopala, all those people, so they are called laukika. Everybody is laukika. Shastra samskrita dhiya. So those who do not have the samskrita dhi, so whose buddhi is not been cultured by the scriptures. So when you keep on listening to the scriptures, then automatically your buddhi starts sinking in a certain way. So that is how the scriptures impart the samskara, the impressions upon us. So our tendencies slowly and slowly change, and therefore our way of thinking and our way of even talking and vyavahar, all of that gets influenced by the shastra. And therefore, and they use also the same kind of expressions and words that are used by the shastra. So that is called shastra samskara. So the buddhi in the samskara, the shastra are there. That is not there, they are called laukika. Then the footnote number 10, pramana hi artha vicharakaha parikshakaha. Parikshaka means examiner. That is pramana hi, so artha vicharakaha. Those people who vicharaka, who deliberate upon the meaning of the things, with so they do not just use their buddhi, but they, in order to determine artha of the meaning, they use the shastra pramana. So shastra pramana hi artha vicharakaha. Those people who deliberate upon the meaning or upon the nature of the things based on the pramana, that is shastra, they are called parikshakaha. So Anandagiri says, laukika parikshakanam buddhau atma abhimana bhrantim. All of these people have buddhau atma abhimana bhrantihi. They have the bhranti of the delusion of taking the buddhi as the atma. Ukte arthe pramanayati. So this commonly observed phenomenon, that everybody, whether educated or uneducated, culture or otherwise, that all of them have atma-bhimanam, that notion of the I-ness in the buddhi. So all of them display an identification of buddhi and take buddhi to be atma. So this phenomenon that is commonly observed is presented as an evidence of how buddhi is the first one that receives the say, atma-chaitanya, abhasa. So ukte arthe buddhe chidabhasattva rupayarthe, as to how buddhi is the first one that receives the reflected consciousness, pramanayati. So the anubhava, the common observation is presented as, here as pramanam, as evidence to support, samarthayati, to support this idea or this prakriya rather. This is again a prakriya, that buddhi is the first one that receives the reflected consciousness. All is prakriya. The reflection, etc., is also a prakriya. Helps us to understand. Tenaiti. So, tenahi, footnote number 4, tenaiti. Buddhehe chidabhasavatvena tadragabhimane sarva avisamvada devatanaya hi shabdha avidvat sangrahartha api shabdha. So, tena. Buddhe chidabhasavatvena. Tena means since buddhi is endowed with the chidabhasa, therefore vivekinavi tadrugabhimane sarva avisamvada devatanaya hi. So there is no difference of opinion with reference to this. That in the buddhi, all these people have the atma abhimanam. With reference to that, there is agreement in all people. So avisamvada devatanaya hi shabdha. Tena hi vivekinam api. What is api? Avidvat sangrahartha api shabdha. What to talk of? What to talk of the ignorant people or people who are illiterate or people who have not had the benefit of the scriptural learning? That they would have vivekina api. Even those who have had the benefit of learning the scriptures, even they are found to take the buddhi as the atma. Tatra atma bhivana buddhi prathama tatana buddhau atma bhivana buddhi. Buddhi here means the notion. So atma bhivana buddhi, the notion of atma in the buddhi, prathama, that is the first one. Okay, then, says Bhashyakara, ततोपि आनन्तर्याद् मनसि चैतन्यावभासुका बुद्धिसम्पर्कात् ततः इन्द्रियेषु मनःसंयोगात् ततः अनन्तरं शरीरे इन्द्रियसम्पर्कात् ततोपि आनन्तर्यं ततो मीन्स् ततः बुद्धेः आनन्तर्यं पाश्चात्याद् आनन्तर्यात् सो देन् मनः मनसि सो माइंड इज द नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज इन लाइन आफ्टर द बुद्धि सो ततोपि आनन्तर्यात् मनसि चैतन्य अवभासता एंड ऑफ द माइंड इज द नेक्स्ट वन दैट रिसीव्स द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द कॉन्शियसनेस हाउ बुद्धि संप्रकाश बिकॉज माइंड इज इन इमीडिएट कॉन्टेक्ट विद बुद्धि सो माइंड इज नॉट इन इमीडिएट कॉन्टेक्ट विद द आत्मा लेट अस से अगेन जस्ट टू एक्सप्लेन द प्रक्रिया यू नो सो we can say immediately in contact with Atma is ignorance and ignorance is contact with the Buddhi, immediate effect and Buddhi is in contact with the mind and mind is in contact with the Indriyas, Indriyani is in contact with the Buddha, the body. So this is how the Paramparya is there or Anantarya, Anantarya Parampara is there. So Tatobi Anantaryat Manasi Chaitanya Avahasara. That's what I mean is Buddhe Paschat मनस अभी चिच्छायता हेतु बुद्धि पश्चात आफ्टर द बुद्धि मनसि चिच्छायता दैट माइंड रिसीव्स द रिफ्लेक्टेड कॉन्शियसनेस व्हाट्स द रीजन बुद्धि संपर्क बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉन्टेक्ट विद बुद्धि फुटनोट नंबर 8 बुद्धि द्वारा आत्मनः मनसः संबंधात् रियली स्पीकिंग टू रिसीव द चिच्छाया द रिफ्लेक्टेड कॉन्शियसनेस It is necessary to contact with Atma. But then the mind has a contact with the Atma through the agency of the Buddhi. That is why. Tata indriyeshu manasayogat. Then that Atma chaya, the reflected consciousness, as though is passed on to the sense organs, manasayogat, because they are in direct contact with the mind. ततः अनंतरम शरीरे फ्रॉम देयर ऑन द शरीर ऑफ द बॉडी इंद्रिय संपर्क ऑफ द बॉडी इज इन डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट विद द सेंस ऑर्गन्स दिस इज हाउ छाया अहंकार द डे द वर्स वाज छाया अहंकार योरैक्यम तत्ताय पिंडवन मतम तद अहंकार तादात्म्यात देह चेतनता मुखदा सो दैट्स हाउ अहंकार बुद्धि और अहंकार द फर्स्ट वन दैट रिसीव्स द रिफ्लेक्टेड कॉन्शियसनेस लाइक तत्ताय पिंड एंड देन Subsequently, up to this body, that reflected consciousness is conveyed. Here I have another footnote which says, Anantariyat Atmanah Sakshat Sannihitatvat Buddhi's Anantari is immediately after the Atma. Ata eva aham pratyekale sarvada ahankarah pratyakshah. Therefore, अतएव अहम प्रत्यय काले सर्व अहंकार प्रत्यक्ष है आत्माभिमान रूपा बुद्धि एंड सो दिस इज हाउ एवरीबडी एस टेक्स इज बुद्धि एज इज आत्मा यथा विवेकम बट देन एवरीबडी एस डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ अहंकार पामराणाम देहे आत्मबुद्धि दैट इज वाई इट्स नॉट एवरीबडी हैज आत्मबुद्धि ओनली इन बुद्धि पामराणाम देहे आत्मबुद्धि दोज पीपल आर द ग्रोसेस्ट पीपल They have the Atma Buddhi, the sense of I in Deheva, in the body itself, or only body only. Kinchit vivekavatam sharira daha darshanena sharira anatmatva nirupanat indriyeshu Atma Buddhi. Kinchit vivekavatam. Those are little viveka. They see the sharira daha darshanena. They see that the body actually is cremated. It's burned to ashes. So how can it be Atma? So sharira anatmatva nirupanat Therefore, they come to understand that the body is anatma, indriyeshu atma buddhi. Therefore, they have atma buddhi in the sense organ. Tataha manasi, there is more viveka, manasi. Tataha iti kramena viveka taratamyat atma abhimana prasag vidha. And so, viveka taratamyat, depending on taratamya, the degree of viveka, then the notion of the atma, notion of the I, varies with different people.
that everybody displays, of course, I-ness everywhere, in buddhi, in mana, but where predominantly? So there are predominantly people who are egoistic, that means their I-ness is predominantly in the buddhi. There are other people who are predominantly emotional, we may say, therefore their I-notion is predominantly in the mana. There are people who are predominantly oriented towards experiencing the sense objects. So pleasure-oriented, we can say that, that means those who follow generally the impulses of the senses, we may say that their buddhi is, atma-buddhi is predominantly in sense organs. And there are others who are not even sensitive to that. They are so gross that the only thing that they can be concerned about is the grossest things. We can say that their buddhi predominantly is in the deha. Everybody has buddhi everywhere, atma-buddhi everywhere, but predominantly, depending upon a person's level of viveka. Therefore, atma-abhimana, prithak-vidha, therefore we find that the abhimana, the identification with the personalities of different kinds. Going to Anandagiri, atmana sarvabhasakatvam uktam upasamma, that is how atma, atma-chayam karoti. So, markadadhi, so manihi, just as that emerald, how it imparts luster to the entire body of milk, and so also atma imparts its luster to the entire personality. And as much as, of course, milk is a homogeneous substance, and therefore we can understand how the luster of that gem can be passed to the milk, but the personality is not homogeneous. That is why this prakriya had to be explained, as to how, from the increasing degree of grossness, how the reflected consciousness is as though conveyed or passed on. Atmana sarvabhasakatvam, that is how atma is sarvabhasaka. For sense organs in turn illuminate the sense objects, and that's how atma is the illuminator of everything. Tat upasamharati, this is being now concluded in evamiti. Evam parampariyena krishnam karyakana sanghatam atma चैतन्यस्वरूपज्योतिषा अवभासते एवं इन दिस मैनर कृष्णम कार्यकरण संघातम द एंटायर कार्यकरण संघात दिस उपाधि आत्मा चैतन्य स्वरूप ज्योतिषा अवभासते इन दिस मैनर आत्मा अवभासते द सेल्फ इल्यूमिनेट चैतन्य स्वरूप ज्योतिषा Atma has a jyoti. What's the nature of jyoti? Chaitanya swarupa jyoti. So Chaitanya swarupa, its own swarupa or the nature of its consciousness, that itself is a jyoti by which Atma so illumines the entire karikana sanghata. Then Anandagiri says, Atmanah sarvabhasakatve kimidi kasyachit kvasideva atmadhihi iti asankyah. Atmana sarva avabhasakatve. If Atma alone is the illuminator of everything, kimili, how come kasyachita, kvachita, kasyachita, footnote number 11, natu sarvasya pumsaha 11, or 12. So kasyachita, natu sarvasya pumsaha, kasyachita means only or somebody. Kvachita, indriyadi anyatameva, somewhere only. Even though Atma illumines, that's what we already read anyway. So even though Atma illumines the entire personality, how can we find that everybody does not have the Atma-buddhi in every aspect of personality, but different people seem to have their Atma-buddhi in at different layers of personality? How come? Which we just said, you know, Viveka Tarthamya. Kachideva Atma-dhiti Ashamya Te Nahi, Subhashaka says. Tenahi sarvasya lokasya karyakarana sanghate tad vrittishucha aniyata atma abhimana buddhihi yatha vivekam jayate. Tenahi, it's only because of that. What is it? Buddhyadehe ukta kramena atma chayatvam tat shabdartha. Since there is a krama as to how the reflected consciousness is conveyed to different layers of personality, sarvasya lokasya karyakana sanghade tad vritti shucha, since the entire karyakana sanghada is illumined, therefore it is conscious, tad vritti shucha, footnote 1, indriyadi anyatame iti yavata. So one of the aspects of the karyakana sanghada is anyata atma abhimana buddhihi. So atma abhimana buddhihi, that identification with different aspects of the personality, is aniyatam. There is no rule about that. There is no vyavastha. Yatha vivekam, only in keeping with the viveka, the kind of discrimination that the person has. Avivekam ittavi chindanti, yatha avivekam, or depending on the degree of aviveka. So, the identification, that layer of personality is found to be different. Then Anandagiri says, Atma Jyotisha Sarvavabhasakatve Loka Prasiddhi Evana Pramanam. So this is the first of all Loka Prasiddhi. So Tenahi, since Atma illumines the entire Karyakana Sanghada, that's the reason why we find people having Atma Buddhi in different aspects of personality. If Atma illumined merely Buddhi, then everybody would have identification only with Buddhi, Atma Buddhi only in Buddhi. Or if Atma only illumined up to the mind, then everybody's identification would have been confined up to the mind only. We find that people have identifications at every level of personality or sanghata, depending upon their viveka or aviveka, but that just shows that everything is illumined by the Atma. That's our interest right now. Or Bhashyakara's interest in showing this phenomenon of aham buddhi in different people is to support this idea, or support the statement rather, that Atma illumines the entire karyakarana sanghata. So, only this Atma Jyotisha Sarvavabhasakatve, that Atma Jyoti or the Atma, that is consciousness, Sarvavabhasakatve, that it illumines everything, tatra Loka Prasiddhiyana Pramanam, not merely Loka Prasiddhi, so Loka Prasiddhi is presented. So, observation of the common phenomenon people was been presented as the evidence to show how Atma illumines the entire karyakarana sanghata. So, Nuru Tadeva Pramanam, not only Loka Prasiddhi alone is evidence, Kintu Bhagavad Vakyam api. But Shastra also is Pramanam. So first of all, Bhagavad Vakyam. So the statement of Lord Krishna from Bhagavad Gita is stated. Because it is very clear. Bhagavad Vakyam is why it is stated first. Because it is very clear. No, that is why it is stated first here. Yathayavi. Tathacha. Tathacha. Bhagavata uktam. Gita su. यथा प्रकाशयत् केकः कृष्णं लोकमिमं रविः क्षेत्रं क्षेत्री तथा कृष्णं प्रकाशयति भारत यदादित्यगतं तेजः इत्यादि च यथा एकः रविः इमं कृष्णं लोकं प्रकाशयति. Just as one sun, or sun being one, prakashayati illumines imam krishnam lokam, this entire universe, tatha in a manner similar to that, kshetri, kshetri means the one who abides in the kshetra, kshetkrutsam kshetram prakashayati he bharata, in a manner similar to that he bharata, that is a similarity only, it's not in the same way. Tatha is that aspect, how sun illumines the entire universe. So also the Kshetri or the Kshetragna or the Atma illumines entire Karyakarana Sangha. That's all. That illumination is entirety, not remaining separate and things like that. So sun perhaps remaining separate from those which are illumined. So that kind of physical separation is there between sun, the illuminator, and what is illumined. That kind of physical separation is not meant between Kshetri and Kshetra. But then, one thing is that the sun illumines entire Karyakarana, I mean the entire universe. Similarly also, Atma, the Kshetri, illumines the entire Karyakarana Sanghata. That is the idea there. O yada aditya kadam teja ityadi. So, footnote number 3. Na tarhi ravi, ravim prakashayadi. Then what happens is, that sun illumines the whole world. Then Atma does not illumine the sun. That is what it is. So, Who illumines the rasan? You see, yatha krishnam lokam ravihi prakashayati, if the sun illumines the whole universe, that means the atma does not illumine the sun? He says, no, no. Natarhi ravim prakashayati naityaha yada. He says, no. Yada aditya garam tejaha tegat bhasayate khilam yat chandramasi yat chayam tat tejo viddhi mamakam. And so he says, no, no. Even this, the light with which the sun illumines the universe, understand that to be my light. That is, I as sun illumine the whole universe. So doesn't want to leave out anything. You know. But this is why very beautiful. To see, you know, why Vasyakara quotes the second one, you know. That is where the Tippanika says. So what is the intention of Vasyakara's quoting the second verse? In case somebody may conclude that the sun illumines the whole world, but sun himself is not illumined, then it is said Atma illumines everything including the sun, because Kshetra. So in the Bhagavad Gita, the 13th chapter, the word Kshetra is explained not merely as Karyakarana Sangata, but the whole universe. So therefore, Krishnam Kshetram Prakashayati, the entire universe is illumined by Atma. Of course, in this sequence, so through the sense organs, of course, the whole universe is illumined. As we said, nāna chidra ghato dharasyatamaha dīpa prabhābhāsvaram, that is how the Dakshinamudhi Sutra gives an example of a lamp in a pot placed in a dark room, and that pot having some apertures, and how the beams of light emerge from that pot and illumine all those objects which lie in their path. Of course, there the purpose was also that how come if Atma is sarvajna or omniscient, how come Atma does not illumine everything simultaneously? To answer that question, this was saying. So this example is given to also say, number one, how Atma illumines the whole universe, but how come Atma does not illumine everything simultaneously? So that there is just as a lamp. Had it been placed by itself in the room, it would have illumined the whole room. But since that lamp is placed not in the room directly, but in a pot, that therefore the light of the lamp is in fact obstructed, and only that amount of light is allowed to emerge as it is permitted by the purchase. And similarly also, Atma by himself would have illumined the entire universe, that each one of us should have been sarvajna. Each one of us should have known everything simultaneously. So how come? Because Atma is a lamp, compared to a lamp, so Atma is the light compared to a lamp placed in the pot. And so body is like that lamp, with the sense organ, the perception like those apertures, and therefore only those objects that fall in the path of these sense organs, they are illumined by the beam of consciousness. This is very beautifully explained, that prakriya, as to how the Atma Chaitanyam riding on the mind, so emerges or goes out through the channel of the sense organs, context the sense objects, and that's how the knowledge takes place. So that prakriya also is beautifully explained. But jānāmi tameva bhāntam anubhāti etat samastam jagat, as Vāśyakara also quotes here. So how, beginning from jānāmi, so that is how the whole universe, so first the illumination is jānāmi, I know, and from there the whole universe is illumined. Then Vāśyakara says further, Nityo Nityanam Chetanas Chetananam Ipiche Kathake. Nitya Anityanam Chetanah Chetananam. Second one is important, Chetanah Chetananam. This is explained by Anandagiri. Nashinam Ayam Anashi. Anityanam Nitya. Anityanam, among those which are perishable or impermanent, he is the permanent or imperishable. So, nāshināmaya manāshī. So, this is the imperishable of the perishable or in the midst of the perishable. Then, chetanah chetanānām. Chetanānām. So, chetanāha chetanānām, the sixth case of chetana. So, chetanāha chetaitārah. That word chetana means those which actually impart consciousness. Chetaitārah. Brahmadeha. So all those conscious beings actually, all those chetana chetaitaraha, so all the conscious beings, tesham ayameva chetanaha. So he is the consciousness of all the conscious beings, chetanaha chetananam. So Chetananam, of all those conscious beings, they are sentient beings, he is the sentiency, he is the consciousness.
Yatha udakadinam anagninam agninimittam dahakatvam tatha atma chaitanya nimittam eva chetayitrutvam anyeshamityaha.
So this is not evident that the atma illumines the whole universe. What appears is that everybody seems to be sentient or conscious by themselves, you know. So everybody seems to possess a consciousness, a different form of consciousness possessed by everybody else, or is it so? That is how chetanaha chetananam.
Yada udakadinam aragninam.
Just as water, etc., which are not really fire. Agni nimittam dahagatvam, and still water and other things burn, but then the capacity that they have of burning is on account of fire. And similarly also we find, beginning from Brahmaji, all the living beings are all displaying consciousness. Are they displaying consciousness of their own? Is water displaying the heat of its own? No. And similarly also, the living beings do not display consciousness of their own, but then they display consciousness that is of the self, just as the water, etc., display the heat that belongs to fire.
Tatha atma chaitanya nimittam eva chetayitrutvam,
and similarly also, the consciousness that is there is only due to the atma chaitanyam.
Anya shamitaha nitya anityanam.
So among the imperishable, he is the imperishable,
chetanaha chetananam.
Among the conscious beings, he is the consciousness. Or of the conscious beings, he is the consciousness. That is how.
Then Vashyakara says further, tameva bhantam anubhati sarvam tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati iti cha. Tameva bhantam, him shining, anubhati sarvam, everything shines after him.
Like the sun shining, the moon shines after.
So, anubhati sarvam. That raises a little question. Shining, shining after.
So, says Anagiri, anugamanavat anubhanam svagataya bhasa syad shankam pratyaha.
Anugamanavat, see footnote number 4. Anugamanavat anubhanam iti. Yatha gacchantam anugacchadi. Ramaha gacchadi, Lakshmanaha anugacchadi, you can say. So Lakshmana follows. So bhati and anubhati. The sun shines, the moon shines after, if somebody would say. Rama goes, Lakshmana goes after.
So when we say that Lakshmana follows, even though Lakshmana follows, still he walks on his own, you know. So Rama walks or is going and Lakshmana follows. But even though Lakshmana follows Rama, still he walks independently on his own legs. Similarly also somebody may feel that Atma shines, the whole world shines after. The Atma shines and the world also shines on its own, even though shines after. So first the world shines and then Atma shines and the world shines, okay. But somebody may conclude that world shines on its own, like Lakshmana goes on his own. So, misha gacchintam anugacchati. So how one follows the other one? Anugachadobi gatihitavat swayattaeva. And for that anugachadobi, even for the one who is following, gatihitavat swayattaeva, his gati is still on his own. Swayatta, he is independent.
Evam bhantam anubhati yatravi anumanam.
So svagataya eva bhasa bhavet anubhanam, sorry. So similarly also somebody may feel that even though the world shines after the Atma, world shines in its own light. So that kind of conclusion can be there because anubhati. The anu means paschat. So shining after. Something happening after is anu. And so, but paschat or that which follows usually is independently following. But here anubhati is not that he shines, the jagat shines in borrowed light. Not shining after. Shining after means shining in the borrowed light. There's a moon shining in the light borrowed from the sun.
So this is all what Anandagiri said,
anugamanavat anubhanam svagataya bhasa syad, and so anubhanam svagataya may happen by the light that belongs to its own self. Isinkam pratyaha tasya bhasa saramidam vibhati. So, tasya bhasa, by his light alone, everything shines. Okay, then, Sri Bhashyakara, yena suryas tapase, teyasa iddha, iti cha mantra varanaha. Footnote number one, yena suryas tapase, teyasa iddha. Yena tejasa iddha suryah tapati di anvayah. Yena tejasa iddha. Yena also goes with tejasa. So tejasa iddha, and therefore illumined by which light? Suryah tapati. So illumined by which light? The sun shines. It is a mantra varnaha. And Ananda says, tatra navedavin manutetam bruhantam, navedavit manutetam bruhantam iti uttatra sambandha.